Watermelon.
Hi there, I'm Bob Eubanks. Can you answer this trivia question? Who was Time Magazine's first Man of the Year? Well, you get the answer to that question and be challenged by many more on the all-new edition of Trivia Trap.
Welcome to the fascinating world of trivia. Our senior team is ready. Playing for the seniors are Gladys Evans, Roy Magdarian, and Candy Doyle. And our junior team is set. Playing for the juniors are Ron Darcy, Lisa Youngheim, and Julie Quirk Gipper. And here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Welcome to Trivia Trap. It's the all-new edition of Trivia Trap with all of our wonderful changes in our show. Really moves along. We have a lot of fun. We ask a lot more trivia questions, and we're going to get to that right now. First of all, returning champions, they won over $15,000 as a team. Welcome back to our juniors. Won't you please? Nice to have you back with us. They're all under the age of 30, by the way. But if you're at least one day over the age of 30, then you're a senior. We have new seniors with us today. Candy, Roy, and Gladys, welcome to our show.
Thank you.
We're glad you're here. Okay, let's start our game with our fact or fiction round. I'm going to give each one of you a trivia statement. You must tell me whether it's true or false. Every correct answer is worth $25 for your team. And we'll go right to our returning champions, the juniors. They have a choice to make as to whether it be the black set or the red set of questions that you want to play.
Let's go with the red ones?
All right. Good luck to you now. Remember, these are the true or false questions. Julie, we'll start with you. Time Magazine's first Man of the Year in 1927 was Herbert Hoover.
False.
That's false. You're right.
Yeah, right.
It was Charles Lindbergh. All right, Lisa. The D in Billy D. Williams' name stands for December.
True?
Yes, true. Good for you. Weren't quite sure about that, were you? Ron, the first Secretary General of the United Nations was Dag Hammarskjöld.
That's false.
You're right, it is false. Come on. The first Secretary General was Trygve Lie. Okay, good for you. 3 out of 3. Let's go right to our seniors now. The black set of questions. Candy, we'll start with you. Insurance companies say the most dangerous sport in the United States is football.
False.
No, it's true. You never played football. You know that one.
Yeah. I wouldn't know.
Boy, when Shirley Temple was 19, she received her first movie marriage proposal from Donald O'Connor.
True.
No. She received it from Ronald Reagan.
How do you like that?
Okay, Gladys, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
The Statue of Liberty has teeth.
False.
Yeah, it's false. Oh. Right. Okay. All right, 75 of the juniors, 25 of the seniors. This time, seniors, you tell me whether it be the black or the red set of questions. Which ones?
Red.
Sure.
But the red ones, all right. Black ones then go to the juniors. And Gladys again, we will start with you. Marlon Brando won the Best Actor Oscar for A Streetcar Named Desire.
Correct. Or true.
No, I'm sorry, it's false. It was on the waterfront. And The Godfather, he won the Best Actor Oscar. Tough for me to say. Roy, you ready?
Sure.
The largest black-owned business in the United States is Motown Records.
True.
That's true. You're right. Good for you. All right, Candy. On Lou Grant, the nickname of the bearded photographer was Cannibal.
False.
False. What was it?
Animal.
Yeah. Okay, juniors. Ron, this is your question. If both Ronald Reagan and George Bush resigned, Tip O'Neill would become president.
That's false.
No, it's true. It's true. Speaker of the House. Okay, Lisa, the oldest synagogue in America is in Rhode Island.
False.
No, it's true. Finally, Julie, when a woodpecker raps on a tree, it's looking for love.
False.
Yeah, it's false. You're right. Looking for food is what he's doing. That's the end of our fact or fiction round. $100 for the juniors, $75 for the seniors. That means the juniors have the advantage, all right? And they'll take that advantage when we come back right after this.
Attention.
Craft your salad.
Trivia Trap, $100 for our juniors, returning champions, $75 for our seniors. The team that makes it to $1,000 wins the game and then goes on to play for a possible $10,000. And juniors, that's important to be out ahead because that means you've earned the right to choose the categories for every question in this round. And the first two categories are children's stories and Oscars. Which will it be? Children's stories and Oscars.
Children's stories.
Leaving the Oscars to the seniors. They're happy about that, I can tell. All right, here's your question. Ron, designed for you. Which country gave us the tale of the little boy who poked his finger in the dike? Is it the United States, England, France, or Holland? Now, Ron, if you give me the correct answer, it's worth $50 to your team. If one of your teammates agrees with your choice and you're right, it's $100. And if all three of you settle on the right answer, $200. So, Ron, which country gave us the tale of the little boy who poked his finger in the dike?
I'll say Holland.
Holland, you say. Lisa, agree or disagree?
Agree.
You agree with
I'll
that?
Agree. Julie, I agree as well.
You all agree?
Yes.
Well, $200. Hang on to each other. Let's find out right now. Is the correct answer Holland?
Oh.
No, it's not. United States. Isn't that interesting? I would have said Holland, too. It was invented by an American author, Mary Mapes Dodge, and first told in her 1865 novel, Hans Brinker on the Silver Skates. How about that, folks? So it came from right here in the United States. No money there as we go back to our seniors who are saying, isn't that interesting?
Yes.
All right, they left you with Oscars, and here's the question. Gladys goes to you. Who is the youngest person to receive an Academy Award for a performance? Is it Shirley Temple, Judy Garland, Tatum O'Neill, or Ricky Schroeder? Gladys?
Shirley Temple.
Shirley Temple. Roy, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
You agree with that. Candy, how about you?
I think I disagree.
You disagree. So two of you agree. That means it's $100 if you're right. Let's find out. Is Shirley Temple the youngest person to win an Oscar? No, she's not.
Darn.
Oh, Candy, you disagreed. You did right, so you can get $50 for your team if you can tell me who the youngest is.
I think it's Tatum O'Neill.
Tatum O'Neill, you say, huh? Let's see right now. For $50 for our seniors, is it Tatum O'Neill?
Yes! Yes.
You're right. Tatum O'Neill, who won for Best Supporting Actress for the 1973 film Paper Moon, 10 years old when she received her Oscar. How about that? Worth $50 for you anyway. Now you have $125. I got two more sets here for you. Let's try this out, gang. The Fight Game or Nobel Prize? Juniors, The Fight Game or Nobel Prize? What will
sure
it be?
Nobel Prize. Maybe Fight Game?
Talk a real loud for us, gang.
We'll go with The Fight Game.
All right, Fight Game.
You want The Fight
that
Game?
Sounds good, yeah.
Question goes to Lisa. Here we go. Jack Dempsey was the heavyweight champion of the world. At one time, he had a sparring partner who went on to become famous in another field. Was it Howard Hughes, John Huston, John Paul Getty, or Cecil B. DeMille? Lisa?
I'll guess and say John Huston.
John Huston. Julie, agree or disagree with that?
I'm going to agree with that.
You agree with John Huston. How about you, Ron?
I think I'll disagree.
You disagree. For $100 for our juniors, was John Huston Jack Dempsey's sparring partner? Oh, was not. Okay, Ron, you can pick up $50 for your team. You must tell me the correct answer. Who do you think it is?
I'll say Cecil. Can I say John Paul Getty?
Cecil Getty, is that who
Cecil
you said?
Getty, that's
answer.
Him.
So your answer
John
is
Paul Getty.
John Paul Getty.
Yes, sir.
The rich guy.
You got it.
You think he was a sparring
that's
partner
what he did.
For Jack Dempsey?
Whew.
All right, for $50, is it John Paul Getty? In a million years, I would have never said that. It was 1923 for an upcoming fight with Tom Gibbons. J. Paul Getty was Jack Dempsey's sparring partner. Write that one down. That's good. I like that question. All right, you have $150. Let's go back over to our seniors. And Nobel Prize is the category that they left you with. Roy, the question goes to you. Which of these world leaders was the only one to win the Nobel Prize for Literature? Was it John F. Kennedy, Sir Winston Churchill, Adlai Stevenson, or David Ben-Gurion for Literature? Roy?
John F. Kennedy.
John F. Kennedy. Let's see. Candy, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You disagree with that. How about you, Gladys?
I disagree.
You also disagree. Roy, you're all by yourself with John F. Kennedy. It's worth $50 to your team if you are right. And let's find out. Did John Kennedy win the Nobel Peace Prize? Nobel Prize for Literature, really what it should say. Okay, did not. You disagreed, Candy. That means, who do you think it is?
I'm guessing at David Ben-Gurion.
David Ben-Gurion. How about you, Gladys? You agree
I'll go with her.
That?
Okay.
You agree
David
with that?
Ben-Gurion.
Okay, so you both say David Ben-Gurion.
Yes.
All right. For $100 for our seniors, is the correct answer David Ben-Gurion?
Oh.
I bet it's Adlai Stevenson.
No. It was Sir Winston Churchill. He won it in 1953. It was the Pulitzer Prize that Kennedy won in 1957 for Profiles of Courage. But Sir Winston Churchill won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1953. No money there. 125 for the seniors, 150 for the juniors. Still hanging on to that lead. As you know, the goal is to get to $1,000. We do that when we play our $1,000 trivia race. See you right back.
Anyone can play.
Attack it, Santac.
Welcome back to the Attack. Good game. $150, our juniors, returning champions. $125 for our new challenges, the seniors. Again, it's the goal to reach $1,000. And we do that when we play our $1,000 trivia race. And we're going to do that right now. Come on, gang. Here we go. Until one of our teams reaches $1,000, the winners then get a shot at $10,000. Junior's out in front with $150. Now, they'll have three chances to come up with the correct answer to the questions. If all three miss, control then goes over to the other side. And remember, each question's worth $100. Ron, you must pick the first question. Home, nicknames, or sisters?
Sisters, Bob.
Sisters, you got it. Juniors, here we go. In Little Women, what was the last name of the sisters?
Smith.
No, Lisa.
I don't know.
Don't know. Julie?
March.
March is the right answer. You got it. Ring knows a lot about a lot of things, I'll tell you. Okay, Ron again. Pick one.
Big Ben. Big Ben.
Big Man. Big Ben. I was looking for Big Ben. Wasn't there. What film features a 100-foot marshmallow man who panics New York City?
Stay Puft Marshmallow.
Lisa.
Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters, yes! Sure. Okay, you're 350. Julie, pick one.
Nicknames.
Here we go. A woman nicknamed Axis Sally broadcast propaganda for the Germans in World War II. What was the nickname of the Irish-American man who broadcast propaganda for the Germans in the same war, the man?
John Connolly.
No. Ron?
Peter Herman.
No. Lisa?
Hitler.
No. Lord Ha-Ha.
Lord Ha-Ha.
Well, there's one for you. Lord Ha-Ha. Scores are 350. Here we go, seniors. Gladys, pick a question.
Captain.
Captain. All right. Here it is. In Moby Dick, on what ship did Captain Ahab sail? Roy.
The Atlantic.
No. Candy.
The Pequod.
That's the one. Pequod. Good for you. Gladys, again.
Character.
Character. What character did Walt Disney bill as the king of the wild frontier? Roy. Candy.
Davy Crockett.
You got it. Yes. Davy Crockett. Sure. Again, Gladys, pick a question.
Okay. Another one. Right. Comic strip.
Comic strips it is. Seniors? In Buck Rogers' comic strip, Buck was just a nickname. What was Mr. Rogers' real first name?
Bill.
No,
Frank. Frank.
Pardon me?
Frank.
No, I'm sorry. Candy.
John.
No. Name was Anthony. Frozen at 325. Back to the juniors with 350. Julie, pick a question.
Themes.
Okay, juniors. Name the classical piece of music used as the theme of the Lone Ranger.
William Tell Overture.
That's the one. William Tell Overture. All right. 450. Ron?
Calls.
Juniors, when pay telephones were first introduced, how much did it cost to make a call?
A nickel.
That's right. Yes, a nickel. 550. Lisa?
I'll take Star.
Who played Hugh Hefner in the film Star 80? Julie?
Jason Robards.
No, I'm sorry, Ron.
Hugh Hefner.
No. Cliff Robertson played Hugh Hefner. You're frozen at 550. Back to the seniors and Gladys.
Generals.
Okay, seniors, time to do some catching up. Here we go. What was the nickname of German General Erwin Rommel?
Little Fox?
No, boy.
Desert
that's
Fox.
That's a Desert Fox. That's who Rommel was. Okay, that's it. 10 questions. Hereafter, the values have doubled. Everything is now worth $200. Candy.
Home.
Number 10 Downing Street is the London residence of the Prime Minister. What is the country residence called? Don't know. Gladys?
Windsor Castle.
Roy?
No answer.
No answer, Roy? The correct answer is checkers. You're frozen at 425. Back to the juniors with 550. Lisa, pick a question.
Bible?
For $200. Juniors, whose head did Salome demand?
John the Baptist.
John the Baptist is the right answer. $750. Ron, pick a question.
Roll.
Roll. Here we go, juniors. Fay Wray played the object of King Kong's affections in the original 1933 movie. Who played that same part in the 1976 remake?
Agnes Moorehead.
No, Lisa.
Jessica Lange.
That's the one. Yes. Yes. Jessica Lange. $950. Julie.
Novel.
Okay, this is for the game and a chance to play for $10,000. Here we are. In what famous science fiction novel do the characters go to the movies called Feelies?
Dune.
No, Ron?
Soylent Green.
Sorry, Lisa.
1984.
No. Brave New World. You're frozen at 950. Back to the seniors, candy.
Swan.
You have $450. Excuse me, $425. You're trying to get to $1,000. A male goose is a gander. What is a male swan? Gladys?
I don't know.
Roy?
A goose.
No. A cob. A male swan is a cob. You're at 425. Back to the juniors. One more, Julie, is all you need.
Disco.
Okay, this is it. Again for the game and a chance to play for the big money. Name the New York discotheque which spawned the 60s dance craze, The Twist.
Studio 54.
Sorry, Ron.
10.
No, Lisa.
Twister.
Sorry. The Peppermint Lounge. You're still frozen at 950. Back to the seniors' candy.
Lincoln.
All right, seniors. When Lincoln was shot, who became president?
Johnson.
That's right, Andrew
yes.
Johnson.
Yes.
Now you have 625. Gladys.
Early radio.
Early radio. The singer Julius LaRosa was fired on the air by the host of the show. Who was the host? Roy.
Arthur Godfrey.
That's right, Arthur Godfrey. 825. Candy.
Meaning.
This is for the game and a chance to play for $10,000. You can become our new champions if you get it right. Julius Caesar once said, Veni, Vidi, Vinci. What does that mean?
I came, I saw, I conquered.
You got it! Yeah! That's right! You are the champion! Great cover behind. Really good cover behind. Ron, a lot of money for you. It ended up at a little over $12,000. Lisa, nice to have you with us. Julie, you're really intelligent. Man, you really are. Overall, you're well over 15, over 16,000 as a team. We'll be right back to see if they got in some big money also.
It's Rent-A-Center's free.
Real service, real savings.
Welcome back to Trivia Trap. We have new champions. Our seniors come in here. Congratulations to you. The comeback of the year. You did great. Candy, Roy, and Gladys, if you are ready, you won the game. Now you have a chance to win $10,000. Go right over there and get in position. Okay, now up until now, you played as partners. Now you're on your own. And your positions over there have been determined by how well each of you did in the trivia race. Candy, you're in the number one spot. You did best. That means you have the first option to play or pass on the first set of answers. So if you're ready, let's begin our climb toward the top, where there's a pot of gold of $10,000. And here they are. Stratosphere, troposphere, ionosphere, exosphere. Candy, those are the answers. You want to play or pass?
I am going to pass them to Roy.
Okay, Roy, what do you want to do, play or pass? Gladys, they're yours. And don't come near me with those answers,
yeah,
I'll
right.
tell you. Okay, here's the question now. You must give me the correct answer. If you do, it's worth $1,000 and a chance to play for $10,000. The question, which layer of the atmosphere is closest to the Earth? I need the correct answer.
I'll say the ionosphere.
Ionosphere, you say, is the
yes.
correct answer.
Mm-hmm.
Let's find out. For $1,000 for Gladys, is the correct answer ionosphere? No, it's not.
Goodbye, Gladys.
Troposphere comes from the Greek word meaning turning and changing. Gladys, we say goodbye to you for today, but you'll be back to join us next time. Thank you very much for being with us, okay? She'll be back to join her team. Here we go again to the next level of our ladder. Candy and Roy, take a look if you would, please. Tommy, Hair, Jesus Christ Superstar, Magical Mystery Tour. Candy, again, you have the choice to make. You want to play or pass?
I may be sorry, but I'm going to pass him again.
Pass those to Roy. Okay, Roy,
right.
The question is yours. Here we go. Name the rock opera written by Peter Townsend and performed in 1969 by the recently disbanded group The Who.
Hair.
Hair, you say. Candy is sorry she passed this one.
I am so
for $1,000, is it Hair?
No.
No, it was Tommy. Pinball Wizard was the big hit from that opera, by the way. Roy, again, we say goodbye to you. We'll see you next time when you come back with your team. All right, Candy, it's just you. As we go to the next level of our ladder, you passed two groups of answers. Can't pass these.
Hope they're easy.
Let's find out. Milk, water, fat, stomachs. Yeah. What does a camel's hump consist of? I need the correct answer.
Fat.
Fat, you say. Good luck to you. It's worth $1,000, a chance to play for the big money. Is it fat? Yes, it is. The hump of a healthy camel can weigh up to 80 pounds, consisting of fat. Congratulations to you. Ready to win $10,000?
I am ready to
win. Let's go right to the top now. There's a pot of gold up there for you. Three's Company, Bachelor Father, The Jeffersons, All in the Family. Here's the question. A well-known American sitcom is based on the British television series Man About the House. What is that American situation comedy called?
Man About the House. It's not All in the Family.
Answer, please.
Three's Company.
Three's Company. Come here, Candy. Come here. This is for $10,000 for Candy if the correct answer is Three's Company. All right, $10,000 for Candy. We'll be right back in just a moment.
GSN makes time for Game Times of All Takes Poker. Then panelists try to guess the player's daily grind on What's My Line. All coming up.
Time for us to go. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Even though the weekend's on the weekend.
Do I get a spin for knowing that? That's life.
The games never end on GSN.
I want to always remember that.
So sit back and relax.
What an amazing country America is.
But keep your brain in the game.
Think about that for a moment, friends.
Tune in to GSN Saturdays and Sundays.
You ain't seen nothing yet, folks.
They're the fun days before the Mondays.
You need one of these once in a while.
Watch GSN Weekend starting at 9 a.m., 8 Central. GSN, get in the game.